10, start. अवज्ञान तिमिरंधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंदेहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरुं वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वतं सावधूतं परिजन सहितं श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य देवं श्री राधा कृष्ण पादान सहगण ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश्च। हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधो दीनबंधो जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांता राधा कांता नमोस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये। नमो महावदान्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायिने कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नामने गौरत्विषे नमः। पंचतत्वात्मकं कृष्णं भक्तरूपस्वरूपकं भक्तावतारं भक्ताख्यं नमामि भक्तिशक्तिकम्। श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासवि गौर भक्त वृंदा। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। जन्माद्यस्यतोऽन्वयादितरतश्चार्थे सुभिज्ञस्वराट् तेने ब्रह्म हृदयादिकवये मुह्यन्ति यत्सूरयः। तेजो वारिमृदां यथा विनिमयो यत्र त्रिसर्गो मृषा धाम्ना स्वेन सदा निरस्तकुहकं सत्यं परं धीमहि। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत्। स्वस्ति अस्तु विश्वस्य कलः प्रसीदतां ध्यायन्तु भूतानि शिवं मिथो धिया। मनश्च भद्रं भजता दधुक्षजे आवेश्यतां नो मतिरप्यहेतुकी। जय गुरुदेव। श्री श्री गिरधारी यमुना देवी पंडरपुर भगवान विट्ठल देव जी लक्ष्मी जी गुरुदेव जी गरुड़ भगवान सबकी जय हो। ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज। सो टुडे वी स्पीक ऑन कात्यायनी। नाउ इज द नवरात्रि। देयर आर 9 फॉर्म्स ऑफ भगवती दुर्गा एंड वन ऑफ देम इज कात्यायनी। कात्यायनी कम्स फ्रॉम द वर्ड का एंड त्या। सो का मीन्स काया, काया मीन्स बॉडी, कायते इति काया, दैट विच मेक्स यू क्राई, इजंट इट? दोज हु आर 40 प्लस आई थिंक विल एग्री विद मी। Though you are still less than 40, maybe they'll say, what is the sign? But anyway, in the childhood you cried. As soon as the baby is born, what is the first thing?
Crying.
And people feel happy if the baby cries. If the baby does not cry, they are not happy. So that's why body is called Kaya. That which makes you cry. And Tya means to tyaj, to give up. So Kartya means by the grace of which you can become free from body. You can become liberated, you can become mukta. Ayana is a tadhit pratya, katyani, feet, we become jayana, like badrayana, another word in Bhagavatam, it's the same. So katyani devi is that which can grant you liberation. So how she can grant liberation? Because she is also called Mahamaya, which keeps you bound here. Because that's what Durga means. Durga means Dustarene Gamyate Tiriyate Durga. That which is very difficult to cross over. You know, like you have many forts, if you go to Rajasthan, they are called Durga. Fort is called Durga because it is very difficult to enter in it. And if you are inside locked, it is very difficult to come out. So this material world is called Durga. And because she is in charge of it, she is also called Durga, long A. If it is short A, then it is, or Durgam Samsaram. So she is in charge of it, she keeps you here. But she is also a devotee, and if we pray to her as devotee, then we can transcend. So Katyayani has a very special importance here in Vraj. There is a Katyayani temple in Vrindavan. Because the gopis, they were worshipping her. So in India, there is a custom. I remember, I was born in a village. So in the month of Margashirsha, which comes right after Kartika, the unmarried girls, they wake up early morning before sunrise and they go to the nearby river, if the village is near river, or a well, and they bathe there and then they worship Katyayani. So I remember this in our village also. Our village is not near the river. It's far away. Yamuna is maybe 5-6 kilometers away. So they will all go to the... There was only one well in those days. And there was no electricity. So it's still dark. So they come, they take bath and then they worship. There is a Shiva temple. So there is a Shiva Parivar, Shiva, Durga, everybody is there. So they worship there. So they worship to get a good husband. Because it is very important to have a nice husband. Some of you may have bad experience of having a not a good husband. So previously it was prayed because family depends on good husband and wife, the children are produced. And if they are not having good relationship, then the progeny will not be good, then the whole society becomes destroyed. So that's why so much importance is given for good marriage. Means good marriage means compatible husband and wife. In Jyotish Shastra, they check this, whether the boy and girl who are going to get married, they are compatible or not. Now this is forgotten. Now there is dating and that has its own fun and problems also. So previously the purpose was different, now purpose is different, so things change with time because we behave according to the purpose we have in life. Previously purpose was dharma, artha, kama and moksha. That the goal of life was not just kama, Now the goal of life is only artha and kama, make money and enjoy. These are the only two mantras. Basic mantra is making money and enjoyment from that. But that leads to a lot of suffering. Krishna says this is problem. Kama esha krodha esha rajoguna samudrama mahasano mahapapma vidhyenama iha vairinam. He says this is an enemy. Jahe shatru mahabaho kama rupam durvasana. So this is an enemy, shatru, killing. Now people think it is a friend. So if you mistake enemy for friend, what will happen? You're going to suffer. So that's the situation. So anyway, Katyayani has got two forms. One is that she is Mahamaya, and that is that she is also Sri Krishna's sister. So she was born to Yashoda, right? She is actually the elder sister of Krishna. So she is also having her place next to Krishna. And it is by her blessing that we can reach Krishna. So gopis knew this. They are intelligent. So therefore they worshipped her, that if you want Krishna, then go to Katyayani, right? Make friendship with Katyayani, then she can lead us to the brother. If you want to reach some big person, you don't go directly. You go through their secretary or some other member, right? Family member, you want to meet some minister. If you know son of the minister, some brother, some other person, then it is easy to reach there. So this is the formula. It works in the material world, it works in the spiritual world also. Krishna also says this, that those who say that they are my devotees, they are not my devotees. Those who say that they are devotee of my devotee, they are my devotee. So that is called dasanudas. So we also take shelter of devotee of Krishna. Guru is a representative of Krishna. If you want to jump Guru and you think you will reach Krishna, he won't accept. Even gopis who are so dear to him did not do this. So therefore, they worshipped Katyayani. So this, you can imagine that this story is described in Bhagavatam, which was written 5000 years ago. And in my childhood also, I saw this happening. So this tradition is coming. Sometimes people say that these Puranas are just myths, the stories, then why it is being still followed? In the villages, still, now villages are getting modernized and everybody has got cell phone, this, that. So I don't know what is the situation now. But I'm sure still things are being followed up to a certain extent. Maybe not exactly the same way. When there was not even electricity, there was no running tap water. There was nothing like that. There used to be just pond, river, well. You have to use water from there. So they worshipped Katyayani for that. And they recited one mantra. Katyayani Mahamaye, Mahayogini Adhishwari, Nanda Gopasutam Devam, Patim me kuru te namaha. So this is the mantra which gopis were reciting. And the meaning is this only, that O Katyayani, O Mahamaya, O Mahayogini, O Adhishwari, please bless us to give us the son of Nanda Maharaj as our husband. We bow down to you. So this is the mantra, this is the prayer. So this is a very nice mantra. Right? Because Krishna is called Jagatpati. Right? Akhilpati, Vishwapati. He is the pati of the whole world. Pati does not always mean husband. Pati means one who is the protector, who is the caretaker, who is the supporter. So that's what he is. He is the Akhil Brahmand Nayaka. So he is Vishwa Bharata, Vishwa Karta, Vishwa Pati, Jagat Pati. So they prayed. And their prayer was heard. Why is that their prayer was heard? Because they prayed with purity of heart. So now what happens is that in our life we pray, but our mind is elsewhere. Otherwise prayer can be immediately effective. If we pray with the sincere heart, if our heart and mouth are together, then it works. Otherwise we are singing, we are chanting, and heart or mind is going somewhere. Mind is somewhere, heart is somewhere, mouth is elsewhere. So there is no harmony. So that was not the case with gopis. Just like when you are very hungry, so then you think of the food, right? Your mind is fully absorbed in that. At that time, if we ask you, come on, do some kirtan. So you say, I'm hungry, need to eat. Right? Bhuke bhajan na hoi gopala. ये ले अपनी कंठी माला सो फर्स्ट बॉडी नीड्स सम फूड सो देर दे वर वेरी हंग्री बिकॉज दिस गोपीज दे वर द सेजेस इन देयर प्रीवियस लाइफ दे वर द सेजेस इन द फॉरेस्ट ऑफ दंडकारण्य एंड व्हेन भगवान रामचंद्र वाज इन वनवास इन द एग्जाइल फॉर 14 इयर्स सो ही ऑल्सो पास्ड थ्रू Dandakaranya with Sita Mataji and Lakshman. So when they saw Bhagwan Ram, they were became so happy. And they thought, how can we have him, our husband, like Sita Mataji? So Bhagwan Ram, he understood, because he is Antaryami also. He is in the heart of everybody. Ramante yogino namante. So yogis, they will Raman in him, he's in the heart. So he said, well, in this life I have only ek patni vrata. I cannot take more than one wife. So it is not possible for me. I cannot even look at another woman. That's why Ramchandra, he had always Sita, when Sita was sent away. Then he did not marry. When that washerman criticized and he sent her away to Valmiki ashram, he could have married. People say Rama was very cruel against women. It's not like that. He was also very harsh on himself. Who could have stopped him if he wanted to marry? No, he was very righteous person. He was very moral. So, dharmo vigrahavan Ram. He was dharma personified. That's why he took so much trouble to go to the forest. Now he asked any one minister even to give up their bungalow. Move to a smaller one, they will complain. He gave up his kingdom, 14 years, big time. And then he lived without his wife for many years. So that is because he was very much fixed on dharma. So he said in his mind that it is not possible, but I will bless you when I come next time. Then I will give you the chance to associate with me. So therefore these rishis, they are the one who were born these gopis. Because all these gopis were unmarried. They are Kumarika. That's how it is described in Bhagavatam. They are not the married gopis. When he did Rasrila, there are also married gopis in that. These ones also joined, but they were also married ones. But this one, who were worshipping Katyayani, they were unmarried. And they were praying, we don't want that our parents marry us to somebody else. That will be catastrophic. We want only Krishna because that is what we wished in past life when we were sages. So you see, the position of gopi is so high, they are superior even to the sages. The sages want to become gopi. So vande nanda vrajastri nam padrenu abhikshna sa yasham hari kathol gitam punati bhuvanatrayam. One dust particle from the feet of the gopis purifies the three worlds. They are so great. Why? Because they are full of love for Sri Krishna, which is the highest. So this Margshirsa, which comes after Kartik, this is actually the fifth season. There are six seasons in India, 2 months each: Chaitra Vaisakh, Jyeshtha Ashadh, Shravan Bhadrapad, Ashwin Kartik, then Margshirsa and Pausha is the fifth, and Magha and Phalguna is the sixth. So this fifth season means fifth Purusharth. So there is Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha, then Prema. So that's why they are worshipping in the Margshirsa. Shirsa, you know, Shirsa means head. Marga, path, you know, Bhakti Marga. So Bhakti is the fifth Purusharth. That is the Bhakti Marga. And they are worshipping in Marga Shirsha, means the topmost path. That is the Marga Shirsha. So this is the Hemanta Mase, Kumarika. So that is the significance. So they worshipped Katyayani, and Katyayani, although people think that she is one of the nine Durgas, right, and worship her, but she is more than that. She has two features, two aspects. One is for this material world, and another is she is in Krishna Leela. So the mantra therefore says Katyayani, means we don't want to be attached to this material body, Mahamaya. So you are Mahamaya. So Mahamaya means that put our parents in the illusion, because we want Krishna as our husband, so change their mind. So how can you do that? He says Mahayogini. You are Mahayogini because she is the one who carried Balaram from Devaki's womb to Rohini's womb. Balaram is Krishna's elder brother. He was actually the seventh womb of Devaki. But then he was transferred to Rohini. So who did that? That was done by this Mahayogini. That's why Balaram is called Sankarsana. Because Karshana means to pull out. So he was pulled out and placed. So she is Mahayogini. So she is, therefore says that you can do anything. An Adhishwari. So Adhishwara means supreme controller. Ishwara means controller. And Adhishwara means who is above others. There are many Ishwaras. But Adhishwara means who is above all the Ishwaras. So she is called Adhishwari. Means she is not some ordinary devata, but superior. So therefore they are praying to her. Because if you pray to somebody to get something, that person also should have some ability to fulfill your desire. If you go to poor person and ask for money, that person himself does not have it. How is he going to give it to you? So that's not possible. I can shift this to the side. Okay. So it is good to be Kripalu, compassionate, but along with being Kripalu, maybe you have to adjust this. You also have the ability to do the Kripa. Otherwise, Kripalu api asmarthasya kastaye Kripaluta. If you are incapable and you want to be compassionate, then your compassion is only a trouble for you, because you cannot help. So it is problem for you and it is problem whom you want to help. So therefore, there should also be samarthya. So Katyayani has the samarthya, that is the meaning of Ishwara, Adhishwari. Means he has the Aishwarya. She has the potency. Aishwarya means we have the power. So therefore they are praying to her. Otherwise you go and pray somebody, please bless me. That people say, please bless me. But you have to see if the person actually has the ability to bless. If the person doesn't have the ability to bless, then you are praying unnecessarily. So that shows that the gopis, these gopis, although they were very young, they were not some grown up yet, but they had this much knowledge whom to pray and how to pray, because they were also doing worship afterwards. After taking the bath, they will make the form of Katyayani in sand and worship that, because Shaktamayi, there are various types of deity forms. Lohamayi, Lepyamayi, Siktamayi. So these are various forms. So they will make that worship. So obviously then Krishna heard the prayers. That's what I was saying, that when you pray with purity of heart, then Krishna hears that, because he is there also in the heart. So sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishto, I am situated in everyone's heart. So then he came to bless them. So this pastime of Krishna is very controversial. That how could he do such a thing? Because when you see from moral point of view that Krishna is coming and stealing their dresses, etc., then it looks a little bit difficult how to accommodate it. On one side we say he is worshipable, on another side we think he is doing this like common people do things. Even common people will not do that, because police will come and arrest you. But if you are the son of the king, you have a little more power, right? So then their prayer was Nanda Gopa Sutam. Why they said Nanda Gopa Sutam? Nanda Gopa, you know, Nanda Maharaj. Sutam means son. Because they could have said, give us Krishna as the husband. Well, Krishna can then be 2,000 people in India who have named Krishna. Then Katyayani would be confused. So you have to be very careful when you ask something, what you are asking. Once there was a couple, they were celebrating their 60th birthday. Not birth, anniversary cannot be 60th, they'll be too old. So they went to beach and they were walking, husband and wife. So when they were walking, there was a bottle lying on the beach. So the man kicked the bottle with his foot. So bottle flew, and from that one genie came out. Because when somebody is possessed by a ghost, they catch and put it in a bottle, block it and throw it into the river. So the genie was very happy because she was released. right? Like we're talking about the Durga, you know, she was like inside, caught in a prison house. Durga also means prison. So she said, ask for a boon. So the husband said to wife, you ask first. So he said that, I give me a ticket to travel all over the world. So, boom, she gave her a ticket, you can go wherever you want to go. And take a cruise and go all over. The husband said, my wife should be 25 years younger to me. So he thought that he is 60, wife is 60, so wife will become how much? 35? So he says, Tathastu, and he said, let it be so. The guy became 85. Then he wanted wife to be 25 years younger. So he said, okay, I bless you, you be 85. 25 younger, your wife? So when you ask for a boon, you have to be very extremely careful. Otherwise you say, Bill, please give Krishna as my husband, and then you have some other Krishna as your husband. And there will be no problem because there will be many Krishnas in India. Krishna is quite a common name, you know. So then all these gopis will be married to different Krishnas. Somebody is Krishna Patel, somebody is Krishna Sarma, somebody is Krishna Yadav, somebody is Krishna, whatever, you know. So now they say Nanda Gopa Sutam. This is being very specific, very precise. So that's another problem, that we pray. First of all, we are not focused on our prayers, and when we pray, we are also not very clear about it. And then when it comes, it may be only a trouble. Like the guy became 85. He was good enough to be 60, you know. So that's why they are saying Nanda Gopa Sutam, that we want not this Krishna, not somebody else or some other name. Krishna has got many names, but specifically to the son of Nanda. So that means they are very clear what they want. And then they say Nanda Gopa Sutam Devi Pati Me Kuru Tena. So what do you want? That you make you Pati Me Kuru. This is a very problematic statement actually. From grammar point of view, it is problematic statement. That make son of Nanda Maharaj as my husband. How is he going to make? The marriage is not going to be done by Katyayani. Marriage will be done by the parents. So she should say that make our parents do that they marry. That is actually what they intend to say. So there are many explanations of this mantra. Because when we read in the story, Krishna was not married to them. Krishna did not marry here in Braja. He went to Mathura, then Dwarka, that's where he married. Rukmani is the first wife of Krishna. So then how is that their prayers were listened to them? So there are very lengthy explanations for this, that how they were married to Krishna now, because they were given some fake husbands. That's why she is called Mahamaya. These are the meaning of all these words. They all have explanation, every word. So Katyayani, Mahamaya, why they are called Mahamaya? That you please create this Maya, that we are actually wife of Krishna, but people will think we are married to somebody else. That is the Maya. This is not only Maya, but it is Mahamaya. That even all the parents, everybody is fooled. It is a Bhagavan ki Maya. Bolten. So this is the Mahamaya. So Pati, Devi. Devi means, so there are two types of Pati. One is the husband with whom you get married. and one is called Devipati. So the word Devi is applied with Pati. Devipati, Patim Kuru. This means whoever we get married, but Krishna should be our Devipati. Devipati means the husband with whom we play. Because Devi word comes from Div Dhatu, Div Kridayam, to play. So they are saying that we don't want Krishna that we married with him, because when you marry, there is no play after that. Right? The play is only before marriage. Once you get married, they only fight. So they said, for fighting, you give us another husband. No problem. But for playing, give us this Devipati. This is the type of husband we want. So that's why it is with Krishna that they played. Right? So that is the significance, that Nanda Gopa Sutam Devipatim Kuru me Kuru Tenam, that you give us this type of husband with whom we can play. So no quarrel, no jhagda, no all this, why you did not bring potatoes, I told you to him, now I need this and I need that, all this complain to another person. With Krishna only playing. They didn't complain to Krishna for this. Right? Krishna was not buying vegetables or fruits for the gopis. Nor did gopis demand for that. For that they had another person who could take care of that. So this is the prayer. So anyway, this Katyayani therefore has a important role here in Vraj to play. That she is the Adhishwari, and she was prayed to by these gopis to get husband. And then you know the story, how Krishna came and then he stopped and he took away their clothes. So why he did that, this is all a philosophical thing. Of course, people who do not understand, they criticize. Because understanding Krishna and his activities is most difficult. Because love is difficult to understand. So, Ahariva Gati Premana. Rupa Goswami says that the movements, the activities which are performed in love, they are very crooked, like a snake's movement. The snake, if you have seen, it goes like that. It doesn't walk straight, like ants. So, activities in love also happen like that. So, therefore, those people who have no idea what love is, they cannot understand Krishna. His activities are beyond common man's understanding. For common man, therefore, Bhagavan Ram is good. Ramayana comes therefore first. Why Ram came first than Krishna? Because first you understand him. And when you become stable and you have understood him, then you can hope to understand Krishna. Because Krishna is not straightforward. Bhagavan Ram was straightforward. His father gave a boon to wife, and then wife sowed, and then he, poor fellow, did not even say that, and he just went. Krishna was not like that. He will say, why are you doing this? He will do all kinds of tricks to them. Or he will say, yeah, I will go to forest, but I will come back in the evening. He will also go. Then I will go again in the morning. No problem. 14 years. He did this for 11 years anyway. Then he left. So, this pastime actually shows that if we want to have Krishna, then we have to be completely uncovered. We cannot hold something for ourselves. As Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Sarva Dharman Parityajya, Mam Ekam Sharanam Braja. So, giving up all dharma. So, it is easy that you can give up your money, you can give up house, you can also give up your family, but to give up your dharma, that is difficult for dharmic people. Of course, these days people are not dharmic. They have already given up. There's nothing to give up. So they think, what is the big deal in giving up dharma? No, first you have to be dharmic. You know, if you don't have something, how you give it up? So they are very dharmic people. Imagine they are the sages from past life who are very true to dharma. So now they are giving up that for Krishna. So Krishna wants to see whether you are really fully surrendered or not. Because he will not accept you. Even if you are 99.999% surrendered, he will not accept. He wants completely 100%. So therefore, he showed this. There is no need for them to do this. There is no need for Krishna. Krishna is antaryami. He is also, even if you are dressed, still he sees you. What is the big deal, you know? You think by covering your body with cloth, you can hide yourself from him? No. He says, sarvasya cha mridhi smriti sannivishta martha smritir jnana upamam. So he sees whether you are dressed or not dressed. But he wanted to see whether you are fully surrendered to do what I want you to do. This is the meaning. People come to Guru, they take Diksha, they say, yes, I'm surrendered. When Guru asks you to do something, as long as it matches your desire, then you are fine with it. When he asks you to do something which does not match with your desire, then why is he asking this? He does not understand. He should know this, right? Then you start doing pravachan to the Guru. Right? So Guru has a problem. Basically, people think becoming Guru is some fun thing. And it's not a fun, because you have to deal with crazy mind. Dealing with your own mind itself is a problem. Dealing with the crazy mind of so many other people, it can drive you nuts. And then point is, you cannot tell this to them that you are crazy. I mean, if you go to a mental hospital, they tell him that you have this problem. So here he has to deal with them and keep them. Yes, you are nice. Very good, very good. Take prasad. So it's a tough job. So surrender means that you surrender. Then you follow what you have been told to do. Don't bring your logical mind now. Logic you can apply elsewhere. You can apply how to execute the order. But don't apply the logic, why he is asking me to do this. Logic has its own place. It's not that you become blind and then you don't now use your brain. No, you keep your brain and now you use it how to do what he is saying. But what people do is that they use all their logic how not to do it. Right? That guru and disciple, they were sleeping inside. It was cloudy outside. So the guru said, check if it is going to rain. So he said, yeah, I see the lightning. There is cloud. So he says, go and find out if it is raining. So he says, yeah, and this cat came and I touched him, it's wet, it's raining. So then he says, then go and get the cloths. We put our cloths on the line for drying, they'll get wet. He says, Guruji, I did two things, third one you do. Why is that I have to do everything? I already do two things, you know. So this is logic, you know. So that is not surrender. So gopis, they demonstrated how they were surrendered, because for a woman to be naked in front of a man in open, this is the biggest surrender she can do. so difficult. So therefore Sukhdev Goswami, when he concludes this pastimes, that is what the people do not understand. He says that trapyacha hapita dridha pralabdha trapyacha hapita prastobita kridan vachakarita vastrani cha aparatani athapyamun nabhyasuyan priyasangi nirvata. This is a very important statement of Sukhdev Goswami, which explains what is the meaning of gopi bhava. People now want to become manjari. They say, give me manjari swarup. You want to be manjari. You have any qualification, even 5%? So dridha pralabdha, they were cheated by Krishna. They are taking bath, they ran away with his clothes. And trapyacha hapita, and he made them give up their sense of modesty, which is very difficult. They came out, they are still, first he said, no, you have to come out one by one and take your dress. So they are coming out, covering, trying to cover their, you know, body. He says, no, not like this. He says, you have actually committed an offense to Varuna Devata, because according to Dharma Shastra, one should not enter in a lake or a river or ocean naked. That is offense to Varuna Devata. So he says, you have entered in river naked. Now you are going to do puja. So you will not get the benefit, because you have to follow dharma properly to get the benefit. If you are not following it properly, then you will not get benefit. So I am not here to trouble you. I have come to help you in this cold, because by the after Kartik, you know, it's already cold. And going and taking bath in the open in the river is cold. They are shivering. Hemant is a cold season. He says, you are taking so much tapas, doing all this austerity, but you are making mistakes. So I have come to correct you. So he says, therefore you put your hands on your head, join like this, and bow down. Then you can take your cloth. So they did it. So therefore he says, trapya se hapita, that they were made completely naked and free, give up all modesty. And prastobhita, they were made fun, he was laughing. And not only he, these boys were also laughing with them. And kridan vacha karita, he played with them as if they are dolls. Do this, do that. No, 10 step this way, 10 step that side, come in front, back side. So then only he gave the dress to them. So vastrani cha aparitani, he stole their clothes. Athapi among, still with all that, they did not become upset with him. Guru asks you to do something, you don't like, you become upset with Guru. Krishna is not their guru. It's not that they have taken diksha from him. He was just a boy from the village. Okay, he's boy, son of Nanda Maharaj. But guru is somebody whom you voluntarily come, surrender, take diksha and accept him as a worshipable. But this, see, this gopi is nabhyasuyan priyasangin nirvrita. Why? Because they were so happy that they got the chance to be with him. So one should feel fortunate to have a guru in this life. Guru Karanadharam, who is the Karanadhar, who is the boatman to take you across the ocean of the material world. So that is what is being described in this pastime, that one should not think spiritual life is some joke or some ordinary thing. It is a very serious thing. And gopis are the ideal, the best example for that. That's why Bhagavatam has this story. This story is not there to show that Krishna was enjoying with girls. And what is the need for him to do that? His anand, he is a rasa personified himself. He is Sachidananda Vigraha. He doesn't need this. But this is to educate us that if you want to get out of this prison house of material world, then you have to take shelter of the Guru, surrender to him, and surrender is shown here by the gopis, that this is what it means. So then Krishna comes and plays with you and dances with you. So that is the significance of Katyayani worship. I think that's enough. If anybody has any question to ask, otherwise we'll stop. Okay? Stop. All right. Jai Jai Shri Yamuna Devi Maharani Ki Jai. Shri Girdhar Swami Ki Jai. Shri Vitthal Bhagwan Ki Jai. Shri Shri Gurudev Maharaj Ki Jai. Jai Jai Shri Radhe Shyam.
Satyanarayana Swami Ki Jai.